Today, we're going to talk about digital multimeters. They are used by electricians, mechanics, hobbyists, and engineers as one.
All over the universe.
It is the first debugging tool for any electronic circuit, and it's a must-have device in every household.
So, in this video, we explain about the true RMS, what are the safety categories, fuses, and digital multimeter accessories. If you would like to see more videos like that, consider subscribing and hit the like button. And yeah, let's go!
To make sure you won't kill yourself, safety first. Read the manual before you start using any digital multimeter. You will find the safety instructions usually on the first few pages.
There is also an essential information on how to use the device and how to prolong its life.
Some of the multimeters are made for small DC measurements, others are made for AC voltages, motors, and can take higher loads.
If you do not have the proper multimeter for the job or you use it in the wrong way, you might blow up the fuse in the best case scenario, but in other cases it might be also your hand or even your face.
So here is a question for you. If current passes from your right hand to your foot, does it pass through your heart?
If you know the answer, comment below.
One of the reasons for an exploding multimeter in your hands is
dumb people.
The other one is a cheap fuse. The fuse in those situations is like your best friend, your wingman, or your power bank. It will sacrifice itself for your life. A cheap fuse will not survive high loads, and it will not tolerate
silly people
that poke their probes into random holes, and therefore it will let all this current pass through the multimeter and blow it up.
However, if you have a high quality fuse like here, your loved one can sleep peacefully at night. The fuse was invented by Thomas Edison, and currently there are a gazillion different types of fuses. In the digital multimeter, you will usually find a ceramic one or a glass one with different ratings.
A good fuse will also increase the overvoltage category of the device.
But what is it?
Well, overvoltage categories go from 1 to 4 and specify the uses and ratings for electrical tests and measurement tools.
Actually, it is based on the division of power distribution systems. Mm-hmm. As the category rating increases, so the available power and the electrical transients, which are instantaneous bursts of energy,
which can kill you. In this table, you can see the ratings and their meanings. For example, if the device is specified as 1000 volts category 2, then it will be able to survive an instantaneous voltage of 6000 volts. But wait a second, could you tell me what is the difference between 600 volts category 3 and 1000 volts category 2? The 1000 volts seems much better.
Well, not exactly. In most cases, the higher the category rating, the safer it is. Look at the test resistance, 2 ohms versus 12 ohms. This measurement current is 6 times higher for 600 volt category 3. So when you are going to buy your new multimeter, think first about the safety category and what is the highest possible voltage that you are going to measure.
Every digital multimeter comes with a set of test leads that also has to comply with the overvoltage category. However, make sure that they are in proper condition before using them, especially if you share the equipment with somebody else. If you think that you need to replace them or you just want to change to the better ones, make sure that they are suitable with your work and with your digital multimeter.
If you have already agreed with us and you are on your way to TME website to get yourself a new digital multimeter, for sure the first thing that you will notice is the price difference.
Yeah, but why do they get so expensive?
Some of the devices have to go through a lot of tests, exams, and even write a thesis.
And we all know how expensive this can get.
So, if the company would like its device to have a degree, a certificate to show how good it is, they have to pay an external company to test it. The more certificate it has, the higher the cost, but at least you can be certain it will do its job properly.
Oh, and one more thing, do not get confused between the CE certification mark and China export logo. Another function that will increase the price of digital multimeter is whether it has a true RMS. The question is, do you really need it? We will explain it in a second, what is a true RMS, but if you're going to work with pure sine waves, like the voltage around the house or residential wiring, you can use a digital multimeter that doesn't have a true RMS ability.
On the other hand, if the sine wave is not pure or is distorted by nonlinear loads like an LED dimmers, adjustable speed drives or computers, go for it.
RMS stands for root mean square, basically a mathematical formula that calculates the effective value of the sine wave. Because AC is changing all the time, we cannot make any sense out of it and therefore we express it in RMS. The RMS value of AC current is defined as a DC current that flows for a specific period of time and produces the same amount of heat.
Now, here is the mathematical operation. It requires a specific hardware and it is very hard to perform. I mean, look at this, I don't need more integrals in my life. So, the shortcut is to use this instead.
In most cases, it takes the average voltage and multiplies it by 1.11, but this is only true for sinusoidal waveforms. Performing measurements on other waveforms will result in significant errors.
Here is a demonstration for you. This is a UPS, an uninterruptible power supply. Unfortunately, it does not produce a pure sine wave, but you still can use it with your house appliances. We are going to measure the AC voltage output from the UPS with a true RMS multimeter and an average RMS multimeter. Let's see what are the readings going to be. Can you see the error? Wow, this true RMS is so precise.
You mean accurate?
Yeah. Now, what's the difference?
Well, accuracy and precision are two different things. In measurements, the accuracy is the ability of the measuring device to get as close as possible to the value of whatever you're measuring, right?
Okay.
Well, in multimeters, you have ranges and those will allow you to make more accurate measurements.
Here we have resistors of about 4.7 kilo-ohms. If we measure it with the highest range, we might not get enough information and install the wrong resistor to our circuit. For voltage or current measurements, you should always start from the highest range and then get lower until you get the proper resolution. Also, before you stick your probe somewhere, check how it is connected to the device. There is a good reason why the voltage and the current are divided.
Accuracy is another very important aspect of your digital multimeter. If you want to understand how accurate your measurements are going to be, you need to know the resolution and the full-scale voltage of your multimeter. Let's break it down into digits and break those digits into halves. A full digit means that it can go from 0 to 9, 10 different states. Now, you tell me. If full is 10, then half is...
5.
2. It makes no sense, but it does.
Using this formula, a half digit goes from 0 to 1, which means two possible conditions. So if I have 3.5 digit LCD display, it means it can display 3 digits from 0 to 9 and one more digit that can go from 0 to 1. The highest display number is 1999 or 2000 counts. But if you think that every multimeter that has 3 and 3 quarters will go up to 4000 counts or 6.5 digits will go up to 2 million counts, I'm afraid you will get disappointed.
Some can go up to 1,200,000 counts or even less, 1 million. You should check it in the specifications.
So, can we still call it 6.5 digits?
Yes, we can. It is just that the highest value that can be displayed on the screen is 1 million counts per range. And if it gets higher than that, you will have to step up, which means that your resolution is decreased.
For example, I can measure 1.5 volts with the same precision of 1 millivolt on the 4000 counts and the 6000 counts digital multimeters. However, if I measure 5 volts, the precision on the 4000 counts will be reduced. If you want to know more about digital multimeters, just ask.
And if you like our video, subscribe. Check description for more information.
Thank you for watching.